Hey, thank you for watching this video. There's more online at Embark Online. You can tweet me, and of course, here's the pie guy. All right, this is first grade, module 6, lesson 11, and in this lesson, students are going to be adding multiples of 10 to any two-digit number within 100. All right, and it's not going to look exactly like that standard algorithm. So parents, relax. Eventually, our students are going to get to the standard algorithm for adding. But at this point, we're really trying to develop understanding and math understanding. We don't want to have our students just following a rule without it meaning anything. So this lesson and all of our lessons right now are trying to develop meaning, and eventually our students will learn that standard algorithm. So let's get started. So let's use 45 plus 30 equaling 75 as our example. At this point, we want to allow our students to demonstrate a variety of different ways for how they know that 45 plus 30 is equal to 75. So one, a student might think of this as, let's see, I'll write it down here. So 45 plus 30. So a student may think of 30 as 10 plus 10 plus 10, kind of like a number bond, in which case then the student would say, well, count off by 10. So 45 plus 10 is 55, plus another 10 equals 65, plus a third and final 10 gives me 75. So there's one way that a student might explain how she knows that 45 plus 30 is equal to 75. Another idea might be for a student to take that 45 plus 30 and recognize that 45 is really 40 plus 5. And then take the 40 and the 30 and say, well, 40 plus 30 equals 70. And then we're going to take the 70 and add in that remaining 5 and get 75. Now, neither of these are the standard algorithm, are they? But that's not the point at this lesson. This lesson is trying to make sure that students get an opportunity to practice their understanding of numbers and number sense. That's going to pave the way towards that standard algorithm later, but at this point, we just want to try and build understanding. And then maybe one more idea that a student might have is for that 45 plus 30, the student might say, well, I'm thinking of the place value chart with tens and ones, and when I model 45, I'm going to get 4 tens and 5 ones. And then this 30 means 3 more tens. So if I'm going to add 3 more tens, that means instead of having 4 tens, I'm going to have 7 tens. And that gives me 75. So that's another way. And of course, some students... Well, let's outline that. Okay, so there's a method. And then one last method over here is some students might go back to that quick tens, and they might model it in their mind with quick tens. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's my 45. I'm going to add in 1, 2, 3, 3 more tens. And so what do we end up with? Well, we end up with 7 tens plus 5 ones. So the answer is 75. So there's a variety of different ways that students might use to explain their understanding. Now, in this lesson, we're going to be kind of focusing on number bonds. But parents and teachers, if you need to scaffold in some way, definitely use some of the other models to connect it to the number bonds. So in the homework, though, they really kind of take a little bit of a step back and just give you a pictorial representation of everything, and that's totally fine. So what do we have here? So here we have 50 plus 2, so that's 52, plus 10, because I see the 10 right here. So if we want to think of this, what's our answer? Well, we can think of 5 tens plus 1 more 10 is 6 tens. So we end up with 6 tens plus two ones. So our answer is 62. Now, is that the only way for students to think of this answer, thinking of it in unit form like that? No way. We can have students count by tens. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, plus 2 is 62. So that's another way to do it. Basically, that's a count all method, isn't it? All right. So there's a variety of ways that students can use. Oh, let's go down to problem C. So what do we have here? We have two tens plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I wish they would have put this in group five, five group notation, kind of like they did down here. But they didn't. That's okay. So we have 26 right here. We have 26 plus what do we have over here? We have 30. So what's our answer? 56. Now, parents and teachers, you're going to allow your students a variety of opportunities, please, to explain how they got 56. There's tons of different ways for a student to explain it. Give your students the opportunity to explain it. And now, here is where we're actually going to work in an explicit use of those number bonds. Now, ultimately, when we're thinking about the universal design for learning, UDL, what we're really saying is give students choice for how to solve these problems. We don't have to tell them, you must use a number bond. But this lesson, we do want to teach students what is a number bond, how to use it, so that later we really can employ those UDL strategies of giving students choice. So we are going to try and really kind of guide our students towards understanding number bonds. And they've given us this beautiful little example over here of what it is we're going to be doing. So we're going to take our 38 in this case, and we're going to think of it as 30 plus 8. Now you'll notice they over here put 64 as 4 and 60, and that's cool also. And now we're going to add over here our tens. So we have 30 plus 40 gives us 70. And now we're going to have 70 plus, and we're going to add in that remaining 8, and we get 78. So of course we know that the answer is 78. Now parents and teachers, this is absolutely not the standard algorithm. This is not where we want our students to end up. But we are using this as a developmental stepping stone towards the ultimate standard algorithm that we want students to learn. But we think by doing this, we're helping students develop an understanding of what these numbers mean. Specifically, we want students to recognize that this is not a 3. This 3 represents 30, as in 3 tens, all right? And this is not a 4. It represents 4 tens or 40. And that's the idea, is we're being really explicit in developing this, like a developmental stepping stone towards that standard algorithm that we want our students to learn. So let's scroll down. Oh, let's do D, problem D right here. So if I'm going to zoom in a little bit. So what do we want to do? Well, first thing we want to do is, let's see, use our number bond. And we'll think of 57 as 50 and 7. And then we're going to add in our tens. So we've got 3 tens and 5 tens. So we've got 30 plus 50 equals 80. Or 3 tens plus 5 tens equals 8 tens. All right, so that's a little bit of scaffolding. Now we've got our 80. And we're going to take our 80 and we're going to add the remaining 7 that's just sitting there. So 80 plus 7 gives us 87. And that is our sum right there. So parents and teachers, I think you get the idea. That's what we're aiming for here in our Common Core. We're not teaching the standard algorithm yet, because at this point we're focusing on understanding. And here is a set of problems where we remove all the scaffolding. We tell students simply solve. And they may use number bonds to help if we want. The kicker here, though, for the first time, we're kind of stretching our students by giving them the sum and a missing addend. So here, let's do A, and then I'll do D. Okay, so if we take a look at A, we've got that 72 plus 20. We get to solve it any way we want. I would have our students, encourage our students to at least think about or mentally imagine decomposing to be 70 and 2. So now we're going to add 70 and 20. That gives us 90 plus 2 more gives us 92. So that's the idea. Now over here, we're going to think of this. The idea would be in a number bond, we're going to think of 87 as right here. We know that we've got a 40. And the question is saying what goes in this portion of the number bond if we want our total to be 87, all right? And so that's the idea. Let our students grapple with this a little bit, especially our first graders. They're going to have to say, I don't know, and do a little bit of backtracking. Or maybe they're going to go up-tracking. For example, a student might say, well, I'm going to start with 40, and I'm going to add 10 and get 50. I'm going to add 10 and get 60. I'm going to add 10 and get 70. I'm going to add 10 and get 80. And then I'm going to add 7, and that's going to give me the 87. And ultimately, what did I need to add? 10, 20, 30, 40, 7. So that's how I added 47. That's just one way that a student might go about solving this problem. Parents and teachers, at this point, we don't want you teaching algebra. Oh, if you have a missing addend, all you need to do is subtract 87 minus 40. At this point, that's not what we're talking about at all. So resist the urge to just jump to some sort of standard algorithm and instead allow your students to grapple with their understanding to find an answer in some way, although it might be kind of an inefficient method. That's okay. And that wraps up first grade, module 6, lesson 11. We're adding multiples of 10 to any two-digit number. And if these videos are helpful, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel.